This video tutorial I will explain RestTemplate client, and we will write the test cases using JUnit. Here you can see database. In this example, we will use MySQL database, and here you can see Spring Boot demo application, which is a microservice. It exposes REST endpoints to create, update, get and delete employee records, and also it has a REST endpoint to get the list of employee records. And here you can see RestTemplate client. We will see using RestTemplate client how to consume the web services which are exposed by Spring Boot demo application. Here you can see Spring Boot application with folder structure. Here you can see pom.xml. Here you can see employee table, and it has two records. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is a REST controller. It has a create employee method, and it accepts request header and request body as employee object. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is post, and this method is responsible for creating an employee record in the employee table. The request header should have this value in order to execute this method and create an employee record. If the request header does not have this value, then it won't create the employee record, and it will return 400 bad request. To consume the RESTful web services, we have to follow these four steps. The step one is auto add the RestTemplate object. The second step is we have to use HTTP headers to set the request headers. And the third step is we have to use HTTP entity to wrap the request object. And the fourth step is we have to provide URI, HTTP entity and the return type for post for entity method. Here I have defined the class Spring Boot application test, and in this class I have written a JUnit test case for creating the employee record. And in this method, what I am doing is I am formulating base URL and creating URI object and creating employee object, then formulating the HTTP headers, and using HTTP entity, I am wrapping the request object, and here I am calling post for entity method of RestTemplate object, and passing the URI and the HTTP entity and the return type. This method returns response entity, and from response entity I am getting the status code, and if status code is 201, then the assert will pass, and this test case is successful. Select the method, right click and run as JUnit test. And here you can see the JUnit test case has been passed. It is green color. Refresh. And here you can see one employee record is created. I am commenting the header setting. Save the changes. Select the method and run as JUnit. This time the JUnit test case has been failed because this header name and value is mandatory, else this method will return 400 bad request. 400 bad request is not equal to 201, so this assert will fail. And here you can see the JUnit test case has been failed. Here I have written another test case to create the employee record, and in this test case I am not setting the HTTP headers. Right click, run as JUnit test. the JUnit test case has been passed because I have not set the HTTP address. But this method expect the HTTP header with the name this one, and value should be true. But it is not there, so this method returns 400 bad request. So we will get status code as 400, and 400 is equal to this 400, so this asset will pass, and the JUnit test has been passed. Here you can see update employee method, which accept ID and request body as employee object. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. Here ID is the path variable, and method is put, and this method is responsible for update the employee record in the employee table. Here I have written JUnit test case to update the employee record, and in this method I am formulating the base URL, and I am planning to update the record which has primary ID 27. This record, and here I am formulating the URI, and here I am creating employee object, and created HTTP headers, and using HTTP entity I am wrapping the request object, then calling exchange method of RestTemplate object, passing the URI and HTTP method as put, and HTTP entity object, and the return type. And this method returns response entity object. From response entity object, I am getting the status code. If status code is equal to 200, then this test case will pass. Select the method, right click, run as JUnit test case. The JUnit test case has been passed. And click on refresh. And here you can see the 27th record has been updated successfully. Here you can see getEmployee method, which accept ID, and to call this method we have to send request to this path. ID is the path variable, and method should be get, and this method is responsible for getting the employee record based on the given ID. Here I have written JUnit test case for getting the employee record. Here I am formulating the URL, and I am going to get the record with primary key 27. This record. And here I have created URI object. Then I am calling get for entity method of RestTemplate object, and passing the URI and the response type. This method returns response entity object. From response entity object, I am getting the body. The body is the employee object. I am printing that. Then I am getting the status code value from response entity. And if it is equal to 200, then this test case will be passed. Select the method, right click, JUnit test. Here you can see the output. Here we can see we got the employee object with the ID 27. And JUnit test case has been passed. Here you can see delete employee method, and it accept ID. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and ID is the path variable, and method should be delete, and this method is responsible for deleting an employee record based on the given ID. Here I have defined the JUnit test case to delete the employee record. Here I am formulating the base URL, and I am passing 27. So I am going to delete the record with the primary key 27. This record. Then I am creating the URI object. Then I am creating HTTP headers object. Then using HTTP entity object, I am wrapping the request header. Then I am calling exchange method of RestTemplate object, passing the URI and HTTP method as delete, and passing HTTP entity and the response type. And this method returns response entity object and from response entity object I am getting the status code. If status code is 200, then this test case will pass. Select the method, right click, run as JUnit test case. JUnit test case is successful. Refresh, and here you can see one record is deleted. Here you can see getEmployees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is get. This method is responsible for getting the list of employee records from the employee table. Here I have defined the JUnit test case to get the list of employees. And here I am creating the base URL. Then I am created URI object. Then I am calling getForEntity method of RestTemplate object, passing the URI and the response type. This method returns response entity object, and from response entity object I am getting the body, and it will contain employees list. Then I am printing that. Then I am calling get status code value of response entity object. If the value is 200, then this test case will pass. Select the method, right click, run as JUnit test case. In employee table, there are two records are there, and here we got two employee records. And JUnit test case has been successful. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.